Same for me, Madam Mayor, yes.
Okay, thank you. Councillor Doughty?
Just by virtue of my profession, I do from time to time put plan application in.
Thank you. Councillor Stapleton?
Exactly the same as Councillor Kennedy.
Okay, thank you. Anybody who needs to leave the chamber, can you do so now? Okay. And again, I will go through the announcements. I've been notified of the following apologies: Councillor Jeffrey, Councillor John Hale, Councillor Warren Brockman, Councillor Joe Walsh. Councillors, we're now going to turn to the purpose of this meeting to consider item 3 on tonight's agenda to discuss clarity on the Council's Greenbelt policy. Your agenda pack includes the request for an extraordinary Council meeting at page 412, and a Conservative notice of motion is included in the agenda supplement. May I have a proposal and a seconder, please?
So we have that.
Thank you.
Seconded, Madam Mayor.
Thank you, Councillor Burrow. Councillor Blakely, I now invite you to move the motion as included in the agenda supplement. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. Madam Mayor, I am aware of the potential sensitivity and issues around Greenbelt and planning as well as discharge of function, so I am not referring to any specific planning applications this evening. It is not the purpose of the new solution. Madam Mayor, Wirral's UDP has a whole series of policies related to Greenbelt, but the one that's most relevant to this new solution is GB2, Guidelines for Development in the Greenbelt. Madam Mayor, I'm sure many of us as elected members will have had applications and awards that relate to the Greenbelt. I think it's pretty safe bet to say that we will all have represented our constituents in opposing them. What this notice of motion seeks to do is give protection to Greenbelt land, but in particular, council-owned Greenbelt sites. Therefore, Madam Mayor, I was delighted when I read the Wirral Globe earlier this year that the leader of council stated, "I'm not prepared to allow Greenbelt land to be built on. I am resolute about that commitment. It is a jewel of Wirral's crown and greatly valued by our residents." Madam Mayor, it's not often Councillor Davis and I agree on things, but on this I call part of the agree. And it's great when we have some unity, as we seem to with the issue of Greenbelt. Madam Mayor, last week a similar notice of motion was moved to the Council by your predecessor and discussed by the Wildwood Committee with a different motion that all members felt they could not support. So in wording the motion before Council tonight, I took on board the views and comments made by members, and I therefore hope that this motion is a fair and accurate reflection of what was said. Sure members will tell me for this. Madam Mayor, Greenbelt is valuable. As well as providing much needed recreational space, it acts as a natural buffer between our villages, towns and communities. And given that there is a shortfall in recreational air community space in Wirral, I believe it is incumbent on us as a council to lead by example in protecting our green spaces. Madam Mayor, I hope the council can support this notice of motion in its entirety. Thank you.
Selective in its quote from my interview, and I believe it's deliberately worded to be ambiguous. And let me explain. I think this administration is, we are resolute about our commitment to protecting the green belt. However, it's the Conservative government that is threatening, most of the threat is above us, green belt, by putting forward top down, completely unrealistic targets for building new homes, a million by 2020. And it's a knee-jerk response to the national housing crisis. And the government have clearly caved in to developers, house builders, and decreed this ridiculous target, I think. So whilst we all accept that we do need to build new homes to meet demand, this administration will not sign up to unregulated and uncontrolled developments in the Greenbelt, which is what the government top-down housing targets are driving us towards. Not everywhere has the same needs, and what might work in London, be right for London, is not necessarily right for Wirral, where we have an ageing population and we have different economic challenges to the south-east. We therefore need to do a number of things. First of all, we must, as we know, by law, produce a local plan, which shows how we're going to meet anticipated housing need over the next 15 years. We've got to do this, because if we don't, there'll be a free-for-all. We open ourselves up to a free-for-all by developers and landowners. We will continue to consult with our overall local plan, and there's further consultation taking place very soon. Secondly, and I need to be very clear about this administration will continue to prioritise brownfield sites, previously undeveloped urban land for development, bring the empty properties back into use, and most importantly, send a very clear message to developers who already have planning permission, it's time to start building. So, as part of the local plan process, clearly you must consult on green belts. However, we should, I believe, Madam Mayor, maintain the existing policy of only approving applications to develop on Greenbelt land if they can demonstrate very special circumstances, as set out in our Greenbelt policies in the statutory unitary development plan. Whether this criteria is met is a matter entirely for the Planning Committee, and that's quite important. The Tory position, as advocated by Chris Blakely, appears to be that there should never be any circumstances under which a site of a Greenbelt can be considered for development. I believe this would tie the hands of the Planning Committee, and it would probably be a breach of planning regulations. So, on a broader level, I'll finish here, Madam Mayor, the Planning Committee will be denied the ability to consider factors such as saving lives or delivering transformational economic growth as constituting very special circumstances. So I think, in conclusion, our message is clear. The government must remove these ridiculous top-down housing targets and let the people of Wirral decide where new homes and businesses are needed and can be built. Thank you, Madam Mayor. Oh, thank you.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. Given the time, I'll be brief. I just want to highlight a couple of points, specifically what Councillor Davis has just mentioned. Firstly, it's guidance from the government about how to apply a formula that this council decides on where we build houses and how many houses we need, not the government. And so I think that's just that's wrong. Secondly, the Conservative government is looking to tighten up regulations about building on Greenbelt. At the moment, in special circumstances, which are quite woolly, and it's up to the planning committee to decide whether, and officers to decide whether special circumstances have been met. This will be increased to exceptional circumstances under the new bill, which issues are explicitly set out as to what constitutes exceptional circumstances. So it's tightening up about the Greenbelt. I think one thing I would agree with is we do need to tackle people who are land banking, get planning permission to raise their property values, encouraging people to start building when they've been given planning permission, like Peel and other large landlords. I think we will agree with you on that. I think that's where we need to target. We need to target brownfield sites and affordable housing. I mean, lots of the Greenbelt site developments that we do get seem to be for luxury housing, and it's not addressing the affordable housing in the world. So I think we should all be agreeing that we do need to tackle housing. It's a big issue for a lot of people in our boroughs. But I think attacking our Greenbelt, once it's gone, and there are other alternatives. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam. I'll be extremely brief. I've actually read the housing paper. The 5-year plan, which they're making the council put in place, it has to show where the housing stock be kind of prescribed councils have to build, it needs to be placed. If you don't put, give a reason where it can go. And there's too much of it to possibly go anywhere in this world and not impact on places we don't want to build. And we lose any right to kind of fighting that one to go to appeal. That's a key point that needs to be made. If Phil and the council don't put this plan together, we lose the ability to block. It's uncontrolled development. Next, the extraordinary measures that you've mentioned, totally. One of those measures is the need for housing stock. So I think that needs to be made clear. If anything, they don't strengthen it anywhere near what you're suggesting. That's it.
speech, because when I read it, I'll tell you about it. When I read it, sort of what hair I have bristled, because I saw, I've done this the same boat. I read this and I saw a threat, because if we haven't got a considered plan in place, someone is going to step in. Now, I happen to read the assessment we did in July 2016, which suggested there might be 8,500 plots available in the Greenbelt if we didn't have a policy in place. Place is under threat. So it's important that we get this consultation, which is, needs to reflect local needs. Now, the government is saying to us, if you don't have a good enough formula, and you can't prove it, we'll step in. So we need a formula that is accepted across the authority, and I think there was one for the Merseyside authorities, but we need to get the figures up to date. Those of us who want to see housing built in the right place want it built to meet local needs and not the needs of the developers. A few weeks ago, I was wandering around the Edgeville Park Estate and I saw some people in a field with the autolites and surveying equipment. They turned out to be a firm from Bolton, measuring a field that is now currently in the Greenbelt. I wrote to them saying, what are you doing? They said, we're working for a client. Took me a bit of time to find out more about it, but there are developers busily measuring land all over the borough, waiting for the day when they can either give us up or appeal, or we haven't got any money in place. Finally, I too, and I think all members, share the frustration that Peel have so much land that they own, and we see little happening so far. Some members tell us that things are going to happen, but what's been promised so far is a fraction of the contribution to the number of properties that were in their original planning application. Do we get all these things in place? Parts of the borough that we don't want to see developed are under threat. I'm particularly making a plea for good agricultural land. Apart from my professional interest in developing, I still take the view there are problems with our food supply that need securing, and I don't want to see land that is capable of being farmed and is productive now being sat on by developers and allowed to go to waste when it could be producing food for our nation.
Thank you.
Now, Councillor
Davis,
can you
make
this very brief, please? It would be very brief,
Madam
Mayor. I'm always getting there.
Thank you.
Just in terms of our three fields contributions, then, every single one of them spoke with common sense at where we are. Let me just say to you that last week, when we were down at the local community, Santi Cabot stood up and basically said, later this month, I will be writing to all the authorities and telling them what their number would be. He said that, and his counterpart the next day, we were in a very small area, Seacombe Water, said, if I can put my hand around his neck, I'll strangle him. So there's the answer between the Tories where we are at the moment. Both sides are arguing, but we need to be consistent. This is a very important topic. And what he basically said is, you must renew every 5 years. So what we've got to do at the moment is build for a 15-year, but every 5 years, look at it. That's the way you have. So that's coming up, that's coming down the line.
Okay,
Councillor
Berry.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. It's been an extremely long night that we all need to get home as quick as possible. You'd be pleased to know this will be extremely brief. Madam Mayor, this is a very simple notice of motion. It's simply asking for the leader of the council to confirm his commitment not to allow our Greenbelt to be built upon. Councillor Davis said he was resolute about that commitment, and I fully support his view that our Greenbelt is the jewel in Wirral Crown and greatly valued by our residents. Our Greenbelt does play a vital role in Bolton Haven's growth and protecting our much loved green spaces, and that is why I was so pleased to read the leader's comments in the Wirral Globe, only to be disappointed that the full council would appear to contradict his quote in the newspaper. So I would like Councillor Davis, along with all elected members, to confirm our commitment to protect Wirral's precious Greenbelt land, and in particular, the Greenbelt and council ownership. Thank you, Adam. Back.